Marronnier is a Japanese horror movie that came out in 2003. It wasn't directed by Junji Ito, but he did help produce and prepare the film. He's famous director behind Spiral and Tomie, so it does have a famous name behind the film, but that's sort of hard because when you actually go into watching the movie, if you're expecting the sort of typical horror movie, there's people that are going to be so disappointed. This film, its only redeeming quality in my book is just the cheesiness of the film. So I'll certainly tell you why the film works, and it's definitely the cheesiness. So leaving the cheesiness out of it for now, Marronnier is just essentially a doll horror movie. That's the sort of tagline that's put on the actual Region 1 DVD release, and it's just essentially that. There's not really much of a story in the film, and that's one of the qualities that does hurt it for an actual person expecting a horror movie. There's not much of a story to go by, and not only that, but I've seen older Japanese horror movies that you can tell that they're older, but they still look okay. This movie just looks downright terrible. It's just not a good looking movie. Even if you sort of like those movies that look like they were shot with a low budget, this one just gets so fuzzy and so blurry in sections that it really will just sort of hurt your enjoyment of the film. Just because of that look, it's one thing to look old, but it's another thing to just have poor production values. But with that being said, there's interesting settings in the movie, and the underground lair near the end of the movie is just great. It's just if we could actually see it and it wasn't blurry, it would help a lot. So horror fans are definitely going to be disappointed with this movie, but people into odd, quirky, weird Japanese movies, this will be right up their alley, because it is so cheesy. And I'm not saying that all Japanese movies are cheesy, but this one certainly is very cheesy. The overacting, the odd looks of the main character, there's a lot of screaming throughout the movie. It all just makes for one, a pretty hilarious movie, and in a sense, that's why horror fans are not going to enjoy this movie. So it's something that, because it ends up being funny and that's the best redeeming quality of this movie, that's why, the people who are used to Japanese horror or just used to campy movies will enjoy this. And that's why I always say going into a movie with the right expectations is necessary. And with this movie, it's so crucial, because I even find some people going into it knowing this may not even still enjoy it. But it's just for those of us, if you don't know Japanese horror, or you don't normally watch Japanese movies, just avoid it. So my advice for most people is just don't watch this film right away. Certainly when I go to watch a movie, some nights I'll have ones in the back of my mind. I'll be like, I've wanted to see this one for so long and this one, and I'll watch them. And then there's also nights where I have no idea what I should watch, but I have the spare time and really want to watch a movie. This is the type of movie that you should watch then. It's not something that you want to watch right away, but just keep it in the back of your mind. And when you go into it not expecting much, I'm sort of downplaying just how entertaining it can be with that cheesiness. So just go into the film not expecting much, and I think you'll come out pretty satisfied. It's not something you're going to watch over and over again either, and it's not something that you're going to maybe want to show off to friends and family. But just for a good entertaining night, this movie's fun. It's a blast. And so in that sense, I'd say watch it.